What's good, everybody? It's your boy JTL, Opposite from the Norm. And real quick, I just want to let y'all know about Opposite from the Norm apparel t-shirts, brought to you by GFAM G-Wear. You like our show and our content? Then go to GFAMENT.com and click on G-Store, and there you can purchase an Opposite from the Norm t-shirt. Also, you can check out other great tees that represent true kings and true queens as well. Shirts that motivate and make you feel great. Once again, that's GFAMENT.com, and click on the G-Store link to get your apparel tees. Now back to the show. Chill! Yo. What's good, everybody? It's your boy JT, Opposite from the Norm. You know what time it is. It's time for some more real shit. So, you know, I'm hearing something I don't like. I'm hearing my partner being attacked. People don't like what we be saying. So this is my thing. You can leave the comments. We always say, leave a comment in the comment section. If you got something to say, you can holler at me too. You know what I'm saying? I'm built for this. My boy, he got a short temper, man. You know what I'm saying? Don't let the glasses fool you. You know, he like Malcolm X. Malcolm X had glasses, but you know what time it was with that strong brother. So we'll leave it at that. But if y'all got something to say, man, just comment. I be saying comment. Leave in the comment section. For those that be coming at my partner, leave something in the comment section, man. We can do this. So since y'all doing that to my boy, I'm going to put myself in lion's den right now. I'm ready for it. So this is going to be women versus hoes. Yeah. I'm doing it. Believe that. So, as you see, we got Asada Shakur at the top left. Bottom left, we got Michelle Obama. Versus top right, Cardi B. Versus bottom right, City Girls. All right, so we're going to break this down so it'll be forever broken. You got a problem with it, come back and listen to this show. Leave your comments. It's whatever. So check this out. The reason why we have so many issues when it comes to sisters taking up and caping for hoes, all right? The reason why I feel, in my opinion, that sisters keep doing that, you have some sisters on the other side of the spectrum that may not like the language that we use. All right, I can respect that. But the problem is, a lot of these sisters also that be taking up for these hoes know damn well what we talking about when we say what we say. Y'all know what we talking about. If you listen to rap music, I ain't gonna say hip hop, but if you listen to rap music, say if you listen to any one of these two artists that's on this page, you know, this picture collage that I got up, you can't sit and act, you know what I'm saying, stupid and act like you don't know what we talking about when we say the difference between black women and hoes. That's what y'all trip me out, and y'all know y'all need to stop. If you listen to rap music, especially you listen to any of these females, I don't want to hear nothing about, oh, you wrong for talking about females. Like, it's a difference between bitches and hoes, and y'all know that. Because you might sit up and take up for them, but are you acting like them? How would you like it if me and my partner HD come and make shows taking up for dusty-ass niggas who don't take care of their kids, taking up for niggas who keep going in and out of prison, keep taking up for niggas who be out there starring shit in the hood that kill innocent kids? How would y'all like that? How would you like it if we say, leave Chicago alone, stop talking about Chicago? How would y'all like that? How would y'all like it if we be like, oh man, 6ix9ine ain't wrong, Tekashi 6ix9ine ain't wrong for snitching? Fuck that. He had the right to snitch because they set him up. I mean, he might have committed crimes with them and had them committed crimes and paid them to commit crimes, but leave him alone. This is what y'all not thinking about. We don't take up for none of that over here, Opposite from the Norm. Like we say, we opposite from the norm, bro. This is what y'all need to start thinking about. Do we take up for fuck niggas and fuck boys? No, we do not. We call them out just the same as we do hoes and bitches. And then we uplift good brothers just like we uplift good sisters. If you don't get that through your head, you don't want to. And the sad thing, I'm sorry to say this, but I'm going to keep it G with you. If you still taking up for hoes knowing you ain't no hoe or bitch, then something inside of you must be a hoe or a bitch. And I'm going to just keep it G whether you like it or not. You must be a hoe or a bitch on the inside, and that's why you take up for hoes and bitches, because we don't take up for fuck niggas. And you know why? Like I said, they out here killing people. They out here robbing, stealing, hurting our community. They fucking it up for the good women out there, leaving them with kids, leaving them fucked up, giving them STDs, fucking over other good brothers who trying to do right. We don't take up for them fuck niggas. So if you taking up for them hoes, that means something inside of you is a hoe or a bitch. Real shit. That's the only way you would take up for a hoe or a fucking bitch. I don't give a fuck what you say. Now, if you see sisters trying to do the right thing, cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they trying to change their life and you giving them guidance and advice, and you know it take time to make that transition. I know that for a fact. But what I'm saying is, what I'm not going to do is take up for some hoes and bitches out here doing bullshit all the time, making all this money, and then influencing our younger sisters to be out here. Do you know how high the AIDS rates is in our community? Do you, and the STD rate? Abortions? Fatherless homes? Single mothers? Do y'all not see that? So we supposed to take up for them hoes and bitches that's promoting that? When you look at these bitches who got all this money and this fame and shit like that, ask them how many times Cardi B didn't probably got an STD, or City Girls, or Trina, or Meg Thee Stallion, or Nicki Minaj. Go ask them hoes how many times they didn't got STDs. Look at what Nicki Minaj do. Look at the type of nigga she married to. Look at the type of nigga that Cardi B is married to. Look at the type of dude JT from City Girls is dating, or the type of dude she has dated. I understand that, you know, people need room for growth. No problem, but I'm not going to sit there and act like it's cool that when you see these stupid-ass bitches do interviews, they sound like bird brains, and then you mean to fucking tell me that I'm supposed to, no, she a good sister. Fuck no. I don't give a fuck if a nigga my brother. If a nigga a fuck nigga, he a fuck nigga. If he a fuck boy, he a fuck boy. I don't care about none of that. If you out here poisoning and not doing the right thing, I'm going to call your punk ass out for it. Point blank, period. And the reason why we need more brothers like me and my partner is because it's fuck niggas out there not handling their business. These same hoes will sit around and turn around and try to say, all men ain't shit. No, it's the niggas you fuck with. And we tired of that bullshit. If you think that's us and we hate women or what, oh, the fuck, well. But I guarantee if you go ask our mothers how we treat them, I guarantee you they won't say that. If you go ask our sisters how we treat them, I guarantee you they won't say that. I guarantee you. If you ask majority of the women around us, I guarantee you they're not going to say we fuck niggas or fuck boys. I guarantee you that. So how could we hate women, especially our sisters, if you mean to tell me the majority, if not 100%, at least 90% of the women around us say we good black men and we handle our business and we look out for our family and our friends? Guarantee you. Go ask all our peoples around us and see if that's fucking true. That's how you know. Now, go ask Cardi B and all them. Go ask Cardi B victims, the niggas that she was drugging and had transvestites coming into the hotel room fucking niggas in the ass while they was knocked out asleep. Go ask the niggas that Megan Thee Stallion was dating that she used to sit there and have fights with. Go ask City Girls, ex-boyfriends and all that. And speaking of that, didn't JT date Kodak Black and then he made a freestyle song from prison talking about he gonna... I don't even want to say what this nigga said. That was some fuck shit right there. But you know what he said about what he wanted to do to her while she was pregnant and the shit he said. And then she get shot at leaving a studio. So these the hoes we going to take up for? That's who we're going to take up for? What about Sada Shakur? So open your fucking ears because y'all want to hear all the other shit. Now open your ears to this shit. What about Sada Shakur? She got falsely accused for killing a police officer. She didn't. She had to leave and go to Cuba and get asylum. What about her? You don't hear none of these hoes talking about sisters like that. Bitches want to take up for stinking ass, and I keep hearing Cardi B pussy stink. And then City Girls, you can see them. One bitch was going to prison back and forth. The other bitch dating all these niggas, and niggas threatening to do whatever to her baby while she pregnant. But we ain't talking about Sada Shakur. All the times that me and my partner talk about her not getting asylum and punk ass 45, this is another reason why we don't fuck with 45. He keep talking about he want to go get her. For what? It was proven that she didn't do none of this stuff. And then they still chose racistly back then to do what they did. So you mean to tell me Trump is pardoning a lot of cats that was criminals and females that was criminal, but he don't want to pardon her? That's a strong sister, part of the revolution, you know what I'm saying, the movement. You don't hear nobody talking about her. Michelle Obama. Now, I ain't saying her situation was perfect with her husband. We don't know behind everything closed door. We don't trust him. But at the same time, you see the sister don't carry herself like no thot. You see that. Where her praise at? She don't get no praise for none of that. Being a Harvard graduate, an attorney, and doing more than just being the first lady. She don't get no respect for that. But Cardi B and City Girls and Meg Thee Stallion is more important than her. Y'all talking about us and what we say about black women. And if y'all were so smart as women that y'all caping for these hoes, why don't y'all leave in the comment section sisters that y'all think need to get highlighted that's not like them? Why don't you go ahead and say, you know what, JT and HD, you know what? How about y'all, you know, speak more about Tamika Mallory? Oh, yeah, I have spoken about Tamika Mallory plenty of times. But y'all don't never give us kudos for when we talk about Tamika Mallory. As a matter of fact, how many of y'all even know about Tamika Mallory? The sister that been doing prison reform and helping with that alongside the brother of my son, who don't nobody hardly talk about. We been talking about that brother and that sister especially. Like, I got a crush on her big time. I ain't gonna lie. You know why? Because she's a real sister. She carries herself like one. She down for her brothers and she down for her sisters. But y'all don't never talk about that. All the times that we spoke about that, y'all don't say nothing about that. Y'all don't like our shows, but y'all don't talk about how we salute the sisters that say fuck a bitch ass, broke ass mentality, broke wise ass nigga that don't want to help his children. We gonna go out there and get it on our own. I'm gonna raise my children up right. I don't want no $50, $60 a month from a fucker. I'm gonna do it. And that's how you have a mother like KD mom who was there for him and pushing them through. Or LeBron. That's what you get, strong brothers that made it through with single mothers, but we don't highlight none of them. Why don't y'all ask about more about Tamika Mallory? All the time I talked about her, y'all don't say nothing about her. What about Ida B. Wells? Do y'all know about Ida B. Wells? Y'all don't say nothing about her. But as soon as we say something about them, you push that under the rug. But then if we go off on Cardi B and City Girls, then all of a sudden, y'all always degrading black women. No, we point out black hoes that make it bad for black women. That's the problem. So if y'all got a problem with that shit, leave something in the comments. Don't be attacking my partner, man. Don't do that to my dog. NN is by itself. I say what I say too, and I stand on it. The only, like I said, we don't take up for dusty fuck boys and fuck niggas. So y'all sisters need to ask y'allself something. Why are you taking up for hoes and bitches that make you look bad? Because we ain't going out there like, oh, I'm finna go beat these hoes and fuck these hoes and leave these hoes. Fuck them. That's why we bring up good sisters. So if you have a problem with it, you need to look in the mirror and ask yourself, why are you trying to take up for stinking ass hoes and bitches? That's your fault. We ain't confused about it. We know the difference. We know the difference. And don't say, oh, your mom and your female friends and sisters, yeah, of course you're going to treat them right now. Because from what y'all say, we hate black women. That would mean we would hate our mothers and our sisters and our grandmothers and all that. And my partner, HD, loved his grandmother death to life. That's all he talked about is his grandmother. And her being the greatest woman he's ever endured in his life. And I have that with my mother and my one of my grandmothers that passed. My grandmother that passed was a strong, you know what I'm saying, old country lady from Georgia. You know what I'm saying? And then other great elderly women that helped me as a man. But the difference is with us, and what y'all don't want to realize is we're not taking the bullshit. And that's the problem with our community now. We sit around and cape for these heifers that's making it bad for all of us. This is what y'all don't understand. These hoes make it bad for you. So when we point them out, you shouldn't be offended by it because we ain't talking about it. If I hear somebody around me say, fuck nigga, fuck boy, I don't get offended. You know why? Because I'm not a fuck nigga and I'm not a fuck boy. I ain't out here treating women like shit. I ain't out here with a bunch of kids and don't take care of my responsibility and help my mother and my family out and look out for my good friends. That ain't me, never been me, and never gonna be me, God forbid. I can't help if somebody, you know, misunderstand what I'm trying to do and be helpful to them. That's on them. But that's not me, and that's not how I get down. So if y'all can't understand that, point blank period, you ain't got to listen to the show. You know what I'm saying? If you do listen to the show, put a comment. Simple as that. Don't run away from it. Comment. I'm here. I respond to comments almost instantly as soon as I get a notification on the comment section, on our page, I respond. If you want to go back and forth, let's do it. And I'm going to show you the difference between real women, bitches, and hoes, in case you keep forgetting. Look at the image on the picture. Which one look like beautiful, powerful, empowering black women, and which one look like stupid-ass bird brain hoes?
Be for real. When you look at an interview with these two sisters on the left, you see intelligence, well-read, dignity, class. You know what I'm saying? Caring, respect. On the right side, you talk to these bitches, it's like talking to a third grader. Come on now. Come on now. Come on now. So if you don't like it, hey, you ain't got to listen to the show or comment. Comment. It's whatever. Believe that. This over here for the smart, intelligent people, especially black people, men and women. If you just got a problem with the language, whatever, just say it in the comment section. It's whatever. I'm here. I'm down. Come on. This is what I do. I'm you know what I'm saying? I'm bred for this. But at the same time, like I said, we gonna keep pointing out holes that make it bad for our sisters and keep pointing out good sisters. And what's so sad, I bet you a lot of sisters I just named, y'all gotta go look them up. I bet you a lot of y'all be complaining, don't know nothing about Asada Shakur. I guarantee you. A lot of y'all don't know nothing about Afeni Shakur background. I guarantee you a lot of people don't even know about who Ida B. Wells is. Just a side note, just give y'all real quick. That's the sister that they try to make it seem like she was the first feminist. She was not the first feminist. She was the first one standing up for black families and her sisters when they get treated wrong. She was for all of us. And they try to say the feminist shit, and I get tired of hearing them putting that on her. But y'all probably don't even know about her. Y'all probably don't even know about Tamika Mallory. All these sisters that's out here doing their thing, y'all don't know nothing about. Y'all talking about us, even though we highlight them, and y'all don't know shit about them. But y'all want to sit there and talk shit about we hate black women, and we highlight black women all the fucking time. Get your facts straight. If you listen to the show, really listen. And I'm sorry they have to go off, man, but on some real shit, I get tired of people lying on us. Don't lie on us. That's real talk. It's your boy JT, opposite from the norm, represent, man. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. We're going to get back at y'all with some more shit. And we're going to keep putting up good sisters and fuck these hoes and bitches. Believe that. Chill.